Hello everyone, I once again welcome you to Lumen Education. Today's session, let us study about question number 2 of exercise 4.3. One side I have written the questions. Let me read the question first. Find the roots of the following quadratic equation by applying the quadratic formula. Now, first of all, you may be confused that what is the quadratic formula? So the formula is x is equals to minus b plus or minus under root of b square minus 4a divided by 4ac divided by 2 into a. So this is the actual formula of quadratic equation. To find the quadratic equation, this is the formula. And what is the value of a, b and c, you may be confused. So if the equation is ax plus bx, ax square plus bx plus c is equals to 0, here a, b and c. The coefficient of x square is a, coefficient of x is b, and the constant term c is c. Okay, now coming to the actual problems, one by one we will solve the problems. And now for alpha, see here we have plus or minus. Alpha means positive. Alpha is equals to minus b plus under root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. And beta is equals to minus b minus of under root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. So these are the two values of alpha and beta. Okay, now previously till now we were finding the values of x. We got two values. X is equals to maybe 2 comma 1 by 2 like this. But now one term is alpha and the other term is beta. Alpha means positive, beta means negative. This you have to keep in mind. And for every equation, you must find these two alpha and beta values. Okay, now solving the first question. The first question is 2x square minus 7x plus 3 is equals to 0. First, let us write the values of a, b and c. A is equals to 2, b is equals to minus 7 and c is equals to 3. Next, we know the formula, that is alpha is equals to minus b plus under root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2 into a. Therefore, b value is 7, minus into minus is plus, therefore plus 7 plus under root b square means 49 minus of 4 into a value is 2 into 3 divided by 2 into 2. Therefore, this will be 7 plus under root 49 minus 4 2 is 8, 8 3 is 24 divided by 2 2 is 4. Therefore, 49 minus 24 is 25. Therefore, alpha is equals to 7 plus under root 25 divided by 4. This can also be written as 7 plus 5 by 4. 7 plus 5 is 12 by 4. 4 1s are 4 3s are. Therefore, alpha is equals to 3. Now, solving for beta. Beta is equals to minus b minus of under root b square minus 4ac. What I do here is shortcut. That is, we have calculated the value of b square minus 4ac. It is present here. Divided by 4 as it is. Therefore, I write those things as it is. That is, minus 7 minus into minus will be plus, plus 7 minus of under root of 25 divided by 4. Therefore, 7 minus 5 by 4. 7 minus 5 is 2 by 4. 2 ones are 2 twos are. Therefore, beta is equals to 1 by 2. Therefore, alpha is equals to 3. And beta is equals to 1 by 2 is your answer. Okay, moving to the second question. Question number 2, that is 2x square plus x minus 4 is equals to 0. First of all, write the values of a, b and c. A is equals to 2, b is equals to 1 and c is equals to minus 4. Now here, first we'll solve for alpha is equals to minus b plus under root d. I will tell you why did I take d and divided by 2a. Here beta will be minus b minus of under root d divided by 2a. the value of d is equals to b square minus 4ac. Why did I do this? Because this will be more simple. You can simplify it easily when you take the values which are under roots as b square minus 4ac. Therefore, b value is 1 minus 4 into 2 into minus 4 is equals to 1 minus 4 to the 8, 8 4 the 32 plus 32 is equals to 33. Therefore, d value you got, that is 33. Now, just replace the d value in the, your alpha and beta things, you will get the answer. See how. Here, alpha is equals to minus b means minus 1 plus under root of 33 divided by 2 into a. A value is 2, 2 into 2 is 4. Therefore, you can write this as, let it be, you keep it as it is. Next, beta is equals to, here beta is equals to again minus 1 minus under root 33 divided by 4. So, these are your alpha and beta values. Okay, moving to the next question, question number 3, that is 4x square plus 4 root 3 x plus 3 is equals to 0. First, let us take a is equals to 4, b is equals to 4 root 3 and c is equals to 3. So, first of all, we will take d. Why? Because it will be easy while substituting the values in formula of alpha and beta. D is equals to b square minus 4ac. 4ac. Therefore, b square is how much? 4 root 3 whole square minus 4 into 4 into 3. This will be 16 into 3 minus 16 into 3. This will be 16 into 3, 16 into 3. This is positive. This is also, sorry, this is positive. This is negative. Therefore, these two get cancelled. You will get 0. Now you got d is equals to 0. Just take this d and put in alpha and beta. Alpha is equals to minus b plus under root of d divided by 2a. Here minus b value is minus 4 root 3 plus 0 divided by 2 into a is a value is 4, 8. Therefore, next beta. Again, beta is equals to minus b root d divided by 2 into a. Therefore, beta is equals to minus b, that is minus 4 root 3 minus 0 divided by 2 into a is 2 into 4 is equals to 8. Therefore, minus 4 root 3 divided by 8. So, here alpha also we got the same thing, that is alpha is equals to minus 4 root 3 divided by 8 and beta is equals to minus 4 root 3 divided by 8. Here you can also simplify. 4 ones are 4 twos are, again 4 ones are 4 twos are. Alpha is equals to minus root 3 by 2 and beta is equals to minus root 3 by 2. So these are your alpha and beta. Okay, moving to the next question, that is question number 4. 2x square plus x plus 4 is equals to 0. Again, first writing values of a, b and c. A is equals to 2, b is equals to 1 and c is equals to 4. And next, d is equals to b square minus 4ac. Here b square means 1 minus 4 into a is 2 into 4. Therefore, 1 minus 16 twos are 32. Therefore, this will be 31. See, here I will tell you a technique. Whenever you get d less than 0, write down this condition, very, very important. That is, whenever you get d value less than 0, you will never get the roots. Roots are not possible. And whenever d is equals to 0 or d is greater than 0, you will get the roots. Possible. Roots are possible. So this you have to remember, because if you judge the d value here only, you no need to solve further. You can write a statement here only that roots are not possible. So this is for today. We'll end this class here only. I hope you have understood all the things, and in the next session I will continue with the question number 3. Till then, take care, goodbye.